Michael gets a new job and moves from his small town to Boston. He likes the job and he likes his new apartment. He likes Boston. There is only one problem. He doesn't meet many new people. This weekend, Michael's sister Kenna is visiting her brother. Do you have many new friends here? She asks him.
Not many, Michael says.
I'm worried about you,
Kenna says.
You're always worried about me,
Michael says.
On Saturday morning, they go out.
Let's go into town, Michael says.
There's a bus stop near here. But Kenna sees a sign in a window, "Visit Rose the Fortune Teller."
No, she says.
Let's go in there.
Michael isn't happy about this. He doesn't believe in fortune tellers.
But Kenna says, "Please, Michael. I love fortune tellers."
Wait, Kenna. But she is going into the house and Michael can't stop her.
He goes in after her.
A woman is sitting at a table in a small room. This is Rose, the fortune teller.
Who is first? The woman asks.
I am, Kenna says.
The two women go into a room at the back of the house.
Michael sits and waits.
After some time, Kenna comes back with a big smile on her face.
Now you go, she says to her brother.
Michael isn't very happy about this, but he goes into the back room.
It is very dark.
Rose smiles and puts some cards on the table in front of her.
She looks at them for a long time. She isn't smiling now.
What's the problem?
Michael asks.
It is not a good day for you today, she says.
Michael doesn't like this.
Why not? He asks.
I can see a black cat, a yellow dog, and a white bird.
Be very careful.
On the street, Kenna asks Michael about the fortune teller.
A cat, a dog, and a bird, she asks.
Are you worried?
No.
I don't believe it,
Michael says. Fortune tellers are always wrong.
But Kenna isn't listening to him.
Michael, she says.
Look at that.
There is a cat near them, a black cat. Remember Rose's warning, Kenna says.
Let's go across the street.
Quick.
I am not worried about a little black cat,
Michael says.
But he walks across the road with Kenna.
There, a man is washing a cafe window with a bucket of water.
Suddenly, the bucket falls.
All of the water in it falls, too, on Michael.
I'm sorry, the man says.
Remember the fortune teller's warning,
Kenna says quietly.
Her eyes are big.
Look at the name on the sign, the Black Cat Cafe.
I do not believe in fortune tellers,
Michael says.
But look at me.
Let's go home. But then Kenna says, no. Michael, look.
Michael looks and sees a big dog, a big, yellow dog.
It is running at him.
Michael can't believe his eyes.
Oh, no, he thinks.
Is the fortune teller's warning right? But the dog doesn't stop. It runs past him.
There is a big smile on Michael's face.
Now, do you believe me?
Michael wants some food now.
He buys a hot dog on the street.
But Kenna is thinking about the fortune teller.
Wait, she says.
A hot dog.
Maybe that's the dog in the fortune teller's warning.
Yes, but it isn't yellow.
Michael says.
Michael is looking at his sister, and he doesn't see the little boy near him.
Be careful, the boy's mother says.
But Michael walks into the boy, and a toy falls from the boy's hands.
It hits the road and breaks.
The boy looks down at the little parts of the toy.
He is very unhappy.
The boy's mother is angry.
Toys are very expensive, she says to Michael.
I'm sorry.
Michael says, here. Please take this money for a new toy.
But Kenna is looking at the boy's old toy.
Look, Michael, she says.
The toy is a little yellow dog.
Michael's face is white. Now he is worried, too.
Now, do you believe the fortune teller?
Kenna asks.
Maybe, Michael says quietly.
He is walking quickly now.
Where are we going?
Kenna asks.
Home, he says.
He looks up.
What are you looking for?
Kenna asks, but she knows the answer.
Her brother is worried.
He is looking for a white bird.
Suddenly, Michael hears a noise.
He looks behind him.
A woman is running after him.
Excuse me, the woman calls.
Yes.
Michael says.
My name's Sally, the woman says.
I'm new here.
The Black Cat Cafe is my cafe.
She looks at Michael's shirt.
I'm very sorry about that bucket of water.
My friend is working at the cafe today.
He isn't always very careful.
That's okay, Michael says.
It is hot today.
Sally smiles at him.
She has a beautiful, friendly smile, Michael thinks.
Listen, he says.
Maybe we can go out to a movie this evening?
Okay, yes, Sally says.
Let's meet at the cafe.
Sally is walking back to the cafe, but suddenly Kenna calls to her.
Wait, Sally, she says.
What's your family name?
Sally looks back.
Swan, she says.
My name is Sally Swan.
And then she goes into her cafe.
Michael looks at Kenna, and Kenna looks at Michael. That's bad. Kenna says. That's very bad.
A swan is a bird, and it's usually white. It's part 3 of your warning from the fortune teller. You can't go to a movie with Sally. But Michael isn't worried. He is putting his hot dog down. He stands and waits. Kenna can't believe her eyes. What are you doing? She asks. Suddenly, she hears a noise. A big seagull flies down. It takes the hot dog and then it flies away. I don't understand, Kenna says. Now you have no food. Michael is smiling. That seagull is a white bird, he says. Now the fortune teller's warning is right: a black cat, a yellow dog, and a white bird. And now I can go to a movie with Sally. Kenna smiles, too. That fortune teller is good, she says. Why? Michael asks. Look at this. This is from Rose for me. It is a good day for you today. Your brother meets a good new friend. In the cards, I can see love for them. Level 1, Beginner. Basic Vocabulary. About 300 basic words. Level 1, Beginner. Basic Vocabulary. About 300 basic words.